Lesson 12. Life on a Desert Island. Have you ever heard of Robinson Crusoe? In this text, we're going to talk about two modern Robinson Crusoes. 大家有没有听说过鲁滨逊的故事？这篇课文我们要讲两个现代的鲁滨逊。But first, please listen to the text and try to answer this question.What was exceptional about the two men's stay on the desert island? 这两个人在荒岛上的生活有什么特别之处？
Most of us have formed an unrealistic picture of life on a desert island. We sometimes imagine a desert island to be a sort of paradise where the sun always shines. Life there is simple and good. Ripe fruit falls from the trees, and you never have to work.The other side of the picture is quite the opposite. Life on a desert island is wretched. You either starve to death or live like Robinson Crusoe, waiting for a boat which never comes. Perhaps there is an element of truth in both these pictures, but few of us have had the opportunity to find out. Two men who recently spent 5 days on a coral island wished they had stayed there longer.They were taking a badly damaged boat from the Virgin Islands to Miami to have it repaired. During the journey, their boat began to sink. They quickly loaded a small rubber dinghy with food, matches, and cans of beer and rowed for a few miles across the Caribbean until they arrived at a tiny coral island. There were hardly any trees on the island, and there was no water, but this did not prove to be a problem.The men collected rainwater in the rubber dinghy. As they had brought a spear gun with them, they had plenty to eat. They caught lobster and fish every day, and as one of them put it, ate like kings. When a passing tanker rescued them 5 days later, both men were genuinely sorry that they had to leave.
So, what was exceptional about their stay on the desert island?They survived very well and were genuinely sorry that they had to leave. 这两个人不仅生存了下来，而且过得还不错。当他们被搭救的时候，甚至有点不愿意离开。但是呢，课文在讲到这两个人之前，第一段先告诉了我们 Most of us tend to go to extremes when we imagine the life on the desert island.就是说我们大多数人在想象荒岛上的生活的时候容易走一个极端 We think it's either too romantic 我们不是把它想象的过于浪漫就是过于悲惨 Then the text gives us an example to show that it can be both or it can be neither 课文里给我们举的这两个人的例子呢说明它可能两种都不是The life on the desert island was hard, but they didn't want to leave when they had to. All right, now we'll look at the language points in the text. Most of us have formed an unrealistic picture. Form an unrealistic picture 是说对荒岛上的生活形成一种不切实际的想法。Form 强调一个潜移默化的过程。所以它经常与这样的字连用 Form an opinion Form an impression Or form an idea An unrealistic picture 不切实际的不现实的注意要与 unreal 这个字区分 Unreal 是不真实的那么 unrealistic 它的反义词自然是 realistic 现实的实际的A desert island, 这是一个词组，荒岛。注意 desert 这个字在不同的词性的时候有不同的意思和发音。当它做名词使用的时候是沙漠的意思。For example, the Sahara Desert, 撒哈拉大沙漠。做动词的时候发音不同，读成 desert. For example, a deserted place, 是一个荒芜的地方，或者没有人烟的地方。The other side of the picture is quite the opposite. The other side 是指这种想法的另外一个方面。所以我们也经常会说 ,the other side of the coin 是指一个事物的另外一面。或者 ,the other side of the story, 这件事情的另一方面是。You either starve to death. Starve 比 go hungry 的程度更为强烈。而这里又用 starve to death 来表示饿死这个程度。当然我们在日常生活中也会用 starve 这个词夸张地说我饿死了。You can say, I'm starving or I'm starved. 引申一层 starve for something, 意思是渴望得到什么东西。For example, the kid is starved for attention. 他非常渴望得到注意。Perhaps there is an element of truth in both these pictures. An element of 是有这种因素，也就是说 there is some truth in these pictures. 那么 an element of 后边呢经常加着一些形容人的情绪或者事物的性质或状态的这样的名词。For example, an element of surprise.An element of danger, or an element of doubt, risk, caution, or an element of jealousy. They quickly loaded a small rubber dinghy with food, matches, and cans of beer. 他们很快呢，把这个小的橡皮艇里头装满了这些东西。Load with 这个词组的意思是把什么东西里装满了什么样的东西或者货物。那么 load 它的宾语呢还可以是其他的东西，总的都是装的意思。For example, load a film 意思是往相机里装胶卷，或者 load a CD 往机器里放 CD 盘，那么还可以 load bullets 是往枪里装子弹。 But this did not prove to be a problem. Prove在这里的意思是 did not show to be a problem. The new device proved to be useful. 这个新的办法呢看来很有用。Prove 这里也是说表现出来很有用的意思。注意呢我们也可以说成 the new device proved useful. 因为在表达这层意思的时候 prove 是起的一个系动词的作用。The man collected rainwater in the rubber dinghy. Collect 这个动词在这里是蓄积的意思。做蓄积或者收集讲的时候 ,collect 还经常这样用。比如我们都很熟悉的 ,collect stamps, 集邮 ,collect coins, 收集硬币。在这个时候呢 ,collect 还有筹钱、筹集资金的意思。比如We are collecting money for the homeless. 这个时候 money 也可以省略，表达的还是同样的意思。Collect money, 筹集资金。As one of them put it, ate like kings. Put, 在这里是表达表述的意思。我要说，这件事情我应该怎么讲呢？ I can say, how shall I put it?Oh, I simply cannot put my feelings into words. Put my feelings into words. 这是一个常用的词组，意思就是把情感用言语表达出来。Both men were genuinely sorry. Genuinely 这个副词是真正的，它与一个表示情感的形容词连用的时候，表达的就是发自内心的。此外 genuinely 也可以表示事物的性质是真实的。For example, it was the first genuinely free election in the country. 这是这个国家里第一次真正意义上的自由选举。这里 genuinely free 是表示这个自由选举的性质是真实的。 最后，我想提醒大家注意一下这篇课文里几处定语从句的用法。首先，我们看这句话 ：Two men who recently spent 5 days on a Kauri island wished they had stayed there longer。这里呢，定语从句是 who recently spent 5 days on a Kauri island， 用来修饰 two men。再看一看这两句。We sometimes imagine a desert island to be a sort of paradise where the sun always shines. 这里定语从句 where the sun always shines 是用来修饰 a sort of paradise. 还有这句 You either starve to death or live like Robinson Crusoe, waiting for a boat which never comes, 用来修饰 boat.第一句话之中的定语从句呢，是我们比较熟悉的一种，它对主句中的某一个成分来进行修饰和形容，对整个句子来说，它是一个附属成分。但是第二句话里头的定语从句 where the sun always shines， 它在整个句子当中占据的位置非常重要，它对 a sort of paradise 进行了补充，而且在语气上强调了人们这种想象的不现实性。第三句里头的定语从句 which never comes 用来修饰 boat， 它不仅在整个句子当中占有的位置非常重要，而且因为 never comes 表达的是一个否定的意思，它使整个句子的意思和语气都发生了转折。所以请大家注意，在英语中呢，其实定语从句的使用非常灵活，它某种程度上可以改变整个句子的意思和口吻。课文当中一开头就告诉我们 Most of us have formed an unrealistic picture of life on a desert island. 为什么会这样呢？因为我们其实想象一个荒岛是为了逃避周围的现实世界。 Because there is too much tension, too much pressure, and too quick a living space in reality. 因为在现实生活中，我们往往有很大的压力，生活节奏也过于紧张。但是呢，一个理想的荒岛终究只是一个想象的世界。课文中说的这两个人的生活，在荒岛上的生活，也许是真实的， But we don't know. What do you think would have happened if they had stayed there for 50 days instead of 5 days? 如果这两个人在荒岛上待的不是5天，而是50天，我们就很难想象他们是否还不愿意离开了。另外呢，我想补充一点，课文中提到了 Robinson Crusoe， 他的故事之所以能广为流传，因为他象征了一个能够适应自然环境的一个强者的形象，就是英文中说的 The survival of the fittest， 适者生存。 Okay, so much about this modern version of Robinson Crusoe. I'll see you next time.